Here's some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Volvo Cars, which surged in early trade after it announced it will stop funding its subsidiary, Polestar Automotive. Shares of Volvo Cars last traded up by 22%. Also in focus, shares of Shell, which beat expectations for full-year profit. It also announced a $3.5 billion share buyback program. Shares of the oil giant are up 3% in afternoon trade. We're also keeping a close watch on Deutsche Bank, whose fourth quarter net profit smashed estimates. Deutsche Bank shares are up 3.5%.
Asian markets started February in choppy trading. That's after U.S. Federal Reserve Chief Jerome Powell ruled out rate cuts this March. Australia's ASX 200 snapped an eight-day winning streak, while Japan's Nikkei 225 fell nearly 0.8%. Philippine shares joined the downswing, with the main index falling 0.3%, despite net foreign buying of about $500 million.
Well, we see a market attempting to breach a robust resistance while forming lower lows. It suggests a potential weakening in sentiment. I think that what happened today during our trading session, it was just some residual activity from funds that are still working on adjusting their portfolio, since yesterday was the month end and they are likely preparing for the implementation of the index rebal tomorrow, which I believe there would be some outflows.
Some notable stock movements in the region. Japan's Aozora Bank saw its shares tank 21.5% as it reported its first annual net loss in 15 years after taking massive loan loss provisions from U.S. companies. Meanwhile, shares of Chinese electric vehicle maker Li Auto climbed 3% Thursday. That's after it reported a 106% jump in its January deliveries.
And here are some local corporate headlines. Land Bank ends 2023 with an all-time high bottom line of 40.3 billion pesos on the back of strong revenues from loans and investments, as well as prudent cost management. Its year-end capital also jumped 27% due to strong profitability. The state-owned bank's financial ratios remain at healthy levels, with its capital adequacy ratio at 16.35% and its common equity tier 1 ratio at 15.46%. Meanwhile, Robinson's Retail Holdings reports a 30% drop in its full-year 2023 net income to 4.1 billion pesos, despite seeing a 7% climb in sales. The company cites forex losses as well as the derecognition of Robinson Bank's net income under equitized earnings after its merger with BPI. RRHI's core net earnings in 2023 also came in flat at around 5.6 billion pesos. And finally, Citicor Renewable Energy Corporation receives the PSE's approval for its 13 billion peso IPO on March 22. EDSA Avedra's renewable energy firm will trade under the ticker symbol CREC and will sell up to 2.9 billion primary shares with an over-allotment option of 435 million secondary shares at 3 pesos and 88 centavos apiece.